Willkommen zurück, meine lieben Herrschaften. Ich bin's, euer lieber Odo. Und wir sind zurück bei Disco Elysium. Wir werden versuchen, die Zeit in Grenzen zu halten. Dieses Mal, nachdem wir jetzt die letzten Male fürchterlich lange gebraucht haben. Oh, wir haben ein Rifle Scope gefunden. Da hat es also. Glacius Passport. Tja, er hat uns, glaube ich, angelogen, was das betroffen hat. Er hat gesagt, er hat ihn nicht genommen. Aber scheinbar ist er doch da. This well-traveled passport, with a stamp in it, issued by the Republic of Orania. You found it in the Phasmid's nest on the island. You can open it for more details.
Okay. This passport, issued by the Sovereign Republic of Orania, is issued to a black-haired woman called Katarzyna Alazier.
Classic okay. Hidden documents from the MT boy.
Yeah, look at.
It's Clasia, with short black hair and glasses. She looks boyish, younger somehow.
Mm-hmm. What was this doing in the fast?
Maybe our man, Mr. Dross, took it from Clasia's, or whatever her name was, hiding place, or.
Perhaps for some blackmailing plan?
Perhaps. But that still doesn't explain how it got into the nest.
The Phasmid took it and I sensed it. So I saw something open up the boy with spindly legs.
Like a magpie? What a coincidence. Then it would also have collected the other objects, which would be highly unusual.
By now, the lieutenant has accepted your unusual methods.
I can see how the helmet could wash up on the island, and the scope. Maybe Mr. Dross lost it, but to seek this out would be very unusual behavior for an arthropod.
Das stimmt. It says Katarzyn.
She said it would be for Anouk Meyer Smith. Anouk Meyer Smith.
Katarzyna Alazia was supposed to be her real name, where Clasia comes from, remember? God damn it. I told you she kept lying to you. She's probably lying to someone else right now, in another city.
Katarzyna Alazia was supposed to be her real name. She lied to us. Maybe this is her real passport, not a fake. Because this is her real name?
Yes, somehow she managed to lie to us one more time. In a way, she's still lying to us right now.
Yeah, what's her real name then?
I don't know,
then?
But it's not Katarzyna Alasia, or Clasia, or Anouk Meyer Smith. We didn't even scratch the surface with her, detective. Perhaps it's better that we didn't arrest her. Who knows what hell she'd be raising in my district by now.
Okay. Inspector Phasmid. Phasmid's gone. Check up on the desert now. Okay. Machen wir. So, aber jetzt. Sie sind verhaftet, junger Mann.
What is it? What do you want from me? I can't go.
Doch.
Something is very wrong with him now.
How could you not see the Phasmid?
See?
Mr. Dross?
The man does not respond. He keeps staring. Black eyes glazed over and bulging from their sockets. his gap-toothed mouth shaking.
Snap your fingers under his nose. Raise your hand in front of his eyes. Touch his shoulder gently.
The plastic cape feels coarse. A light shiver passes the man. Other than that, no reaction. He feels small and frail.
He's going into some kind of psychomotor immobility. The good news is, this solves our transportation problem, doesn't it, Mr. Dross?
The trembling mouth appears to sigh.
Between this and the broken tire he's used for a boat, I think it's safe to leave him here, while we go and get help. It will need to be medical first, I'm afraid.
What has happened to this man?
Old age and shock.
Old age and shock, yes. I think it's the phasmid.
Yes, the arrest and the appearance of the phasmid, the combined stress. But you think it's something more than that, don't you?
Pick up the
There's Zima. Much more. Remember what it said when it spoke.
Nein, kann ich nicht, weil das war gestern. He couldn't see it, Kim. It's just the reads for him. He's been here for a long time. Who knows how much of it in its company.
He did seem distressed when it finally came to arresting him. Like he didn't want to leave this place. And the insect, maybe. I have absolutely forgotten to take notes. I hope I remember all of this. This will be one hell of a report. Thank God we have the photo.
No one would believe you without it.
We found some things in the phasmid's nest.
He stares into the reeds. Your words don't stir anything in him. Perhaps you should.
Oh, this is the ceramic helmet. This is the helm von dem Typen, den erschossen hat.
Nothing. Just dull staring. Not even rage left, wherever he is.
If Kuno kicked it into the sea, as he said he did, the ebb would pull it back here. This makes sense. Mr. Dross could have picked it up. Or the phasmid, even. If it did, this is incredible.
No reaction. His breathing is slow, and he appears very old all of a sudden. Around 80.
Did you take this passport and other papers from a boy on the coast?
The spirit.
Okay.
He hears us. The spirit?
No reply. He's gone again.
Try something else? We got him back for a moment.
Show him the detached.
I lost.
You lost it, Mr. Dross.
He turns his eyes to the reeds again, as he's done so many times. Beige and white stripes.
He lost the scope. Then it somehow made its way over there. With the help of a magpie phasmid.
The lieutenant observes the lens sparkle in your hand.
This sight is a T9, Mr. Dross. Was it attached to the rifle when you made the shot?
Silence. Not even a sigh. You've gotten all you will out of this poor being.
I'm going to let you rest, Hans.
The plastic cape flaps around his face in a gust of wind. His back is slouched and his mouth open. The blacks of his eyes are receding. His pupils are returning to normal.
Hang tight.
We should think about getting back to the mainland to get help. He'll be safe here if we don't take too long.
Okay. Das machen wir. Lass uns zurückgehen und Hilfe holen. Das war nicht Disco. Das war alles andere als Disco. Ich glaube, wir haben den Fall und das Spiel gelöst. Das war's.
The dry grass crackles under your feet as you stop. Far away, birds' wings touch the still surface of the sea.
What is that flutter?
The flock of quail departs, now more than 100 meters away, 102, 105.
Underneath
on the
flutter.
Islet, there is almost no wind, just snow quietly falling on the reeds, bulrushes swaying on the waterline, long dried leaves chafing against each other. Like a silent orchestra tuning at the beginning of some major work. Of great importance to the few who attend.
Beyond that, further north. Kim.
Yes?
Momentarily, the sounds are swept away. Pain shoots up your right foot and into your groin.
It's pretty silent on this island.
It is. Is that why we are stopping?
Wait, I have to list one more thing.
The lieutenant nods in silence. A silent hiss. Sea air moving through the needles of a pine tree. The faraway roar of the city. Distant like today's dream. Before it, the sound of sand. The low tide filtered through its grains. A bird tending to its feathers. Snow falls on the water, melting away without even a whisper. A low hum. The air slowly moves through a concrete box, through its ancient slits and cracks, resonating, hollow. A big building.
North.
Air flows out of a pillbox window. There is very little there. The air cossets flowers on a meadow. Absolute silence. Reeds motionless. Bulrushes motionless. A flake of snow falls on an extinguished campfire. Hiss.
Was soll's?
A jitter. A sound impatient to happen, but not yet in this world. You hear some kind of limb fidget, producing an imperceptible tick. No, it's just your imagination. You can't hear such things.
Danke, Logic. Zurück zum Boot.
The skiff is swaying on the waves by the dock.
Let's return to the mainland.
We are done here.
Achso, wir müssen auf Continue drücken.
The skiff rocks gently under your weight as you get in. The ride back is uneventful. And quiet.
Can radio FM.
But for the sound of conversation on the water, there is someone inland waiting for you.
Meine Kollegen.
Two men and a woman stand on the concrete square of a nameless village, looking at a small yellow boat as it draws closer. The sea is calm. You reach the jetty and climb out of the skiff.
Oh, Lillian ist weg.
Look what the tide brought him.
Sean. Suddenly his expression changes and he tilts his head.
You look like a fucking clown, Harry. Not like a funny police officer, but like a real-life, full-time, pie-in-the-face, unicycle-riding circus employee.
Ja, das mag vielleicht sein, aber ich habe den Fall gelöst.
Whatever this is, it is completely unimportant compared to what you've just seen. This is the man with sunglasses from the Whirling in Rags. But where are his sunglasses?
I forget about all this giant. No one else seems bothered by my style.
Bothered by it? Harry, you're a goddamn cop. They're afraid of you. Actually, are you? Are you still a cop? There's so much disco going on, it's hard to tell.
Im Gegensatz zu dir habe ich den Fall gelöst, du Idiot.
Vic, calm down.
Hello, Trent Heilerstein. I believe we've met on several occasions.
I'm your goddamn partner, Jean Vicomar, and this is your special task force, or what's left of it.
Mm-hmm.
Special consultant Trent Heidelstam, patrol officer Judith Minot.
Hi.
We've come to scrape what's left of you off the pavement.
Lieutenant Kim Kisuragi, prison 57. We've just come from the island where our investigation led us.
The scene is making even him feel as though he has to justify your actions.
Oh, I'm
we
a
might
Kim.
Need your help with something later.
As if he recalled that he's in fact a decorated police lieutenant and not a naughty boy.
But this is clearly a departmental matter, so I'm going to leave you to discuss it among yourselves.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Way to feed me to the wolves. No, Kim, you've gotta have my back. That's it.
It's good to meet you, Lieutenant Kitsuhagi.
Letting the lieutenant know he shouldn't feel embarrassed over the shitstorm that's about to befall you.
What is this about? Look at about all this giant. Nein, wir sagen nichts von mit.
Ari, we want to help you. Trent, I believe this is where you come in?
I don't quite know what I'm doing here. I was asked to participate as an expert. I think I need to manage your expectations a little. I'm at best an enthusiast in cognitive science. My background is in something else entirely. I engage
warte
in
mal.
Neurology on a merely theoretical level. In fact, I should probably get going.
Ist es nicht der Typ mit seinem Sohn? Ich glaube fast.
No, Trent, it's too late. You're part of this shit now. What have you got to say for yourself, shit kid?
What does he have to say for himself? He left you to catch the bullets. Shit, kid. What an interest in Monica.
How did you know I was here? You aren't the man with the sunglasses at all. You're not even blonde. You never told me you're not a horse-faced woman. So Trent Heddlestem turns out to be special consultant Trent Heddlestem.
Yes. I'm Trent Heilerstein. I never said I wasn't Trent Heilerstein.
Wait, what was up with the kid then?
Mikael? Mikael's my son.
Oh yeah? What was up with all the interesting history? Spying on me?
No, I was just interested in the Feld building and the Martinez beachhead. And Mikael wanted to see Martinez. It was a coincidence.
What you are you special consulting here?
What indeed? I was asked to share my take on some of the more obscure theories developed in Königstein in the 30s, like partial psychotraumatic amnesia, group personality theory.
Mm-hmm.
He's here to see if you're insane. He is smart. Let's move on.
Duped again? No one's who they say they are.
Duped? Hey, here's a brilliant idea. Don't be a morbid drunk and you won't be duped so easily.
Gardener, scab leader, this turned to the lieutenant. Tell me at least you are who you said you were. Okay, that does have some bit, yes?
Yes, I'm still Kinki Soragi, still a lieutenant from prison 57.
Oh, Kim ist der einzig Gute.
Still caught up in this crossfire, too.
Where have you been all this time? There was a mercenary tribunal.
God damn it, Harry.
Crosses his arms and looks you in the eye.
You told us to fuck off. You said we're cramping your style. Your detective god. Fuck everything. All we burn. Detect or die.
Wait, so you let me face a squad of trained killers alone just to teach me a lesson?
It wasn't like that.
Fuck you, Harry. We didn't know there was gonna be a tribunal, did we?
All will burn, Satellite Officer Wickmeyer. Make no mistake about it. Why didn't you detect or die then? Why would you leave a literal police god? That all those things? I'm not like that anymore.
Yep. Here we go. Alcoholic delirium. Visions. All must pay.
What did kid? How did you know I was here?
The cafeteria manager you fucked over told us where you went.
I saved his establishment and still he betrays me. Turn to face the general direction of the wording and yell, "Damn you, cafeteria manager! You've betrayed me for the last time." I understand. Okay. God told you.
People on the street helped us too, with your whereabouts.
You're a legend among the drunks, Harry. A legendary local drunk.
Yeah. Immerhin bin ich eine Legend. You never told me you're not the horse-faced woman. You aren't the man with sunglasses at all. You're not even blonde.
Guilty as charged. I heard you'd lost your mind and your memory. I wanted to see if it was true. And it was. Good work, Harry. You're insane now. There's one less person for me and everyone else to rely on.
Mm-hmm.
He was too sarcastic for you to realize who he was.
Actually, I suspected something was off. Maybe if you hadn't been so sarcastic, I would have realized I knew you.
I'm clinically depressed, Harry. Sorry if I wasn't in the mood to butter you up after you told us to fuck off.
Actually, I suspected something was off. I don't like being lied to.
I didn't lie to you. No one lies to you. You were so fucked up on booze you couldn't recognize your own partner.
Okay.
The bears are drinking because you have brain damage. Trant, this is where you come in. How bad is it?
Well, he doesn't have visible tremors. He talks without slurring. He can drive a boat. He's standing, reasoning. All good signs, but complete retrograde amnesia. Episodic and semantic.
Meaning, you forgot both who you are and the definitions of money, Isola, Pell, and so on.
Okay.
As displayed in a station call, our interactions with him and... I don't want to be a snitch, but also mine with him before when Harry did not seem to know who I was. It's all very interesting.
Interesting?
Yes, interesting. I have my theories, but I would like to hear Harry's thoughts first. Harry, what do you think happened to you? Neurologically, psychologically, and why not socioeconomically?
Zumindest scheint eher kein allzu schlechter Mensch zu sein. Wait, socioeconomically? You think I'm so poor I lost my memory?
Not when you phrase it like that. But I don't think critical theory... I know everyone thinks this is far-fetched pink academia, but still. I don't think it should be off the table here.
What? He lost his memory because of capitalism?
Warum nicht? Sollen schon schlimmere Dinge passiert sein. Okay, wir werden dieses zweite Tribunal verlassen, Herrschaften. Und das nächste Mal werden wir dieses Spiel zu Ende spielen. Aber nachdem dieses Gespräch noch recht lang dauern kann, denke ich mir, Schluss machen wir. Und das nächste Mal, wie schon gesagt, machen wir ein Ende. Dann, Spaß.